Let's fix your clogged Dyson. Come on, let's do this.
Vacuum is not sucking. You have to lock the mail.
Yeah, because we're going to make your vacuum work. If you got a Dyson, any kind of model, I actually have three different models. And I'm going to show you guys when they stop sucking because it's not told in the manual. And we're going to fix it, right? Let's go over the things that can make it get clogged and lose suction. Here we go.
Where are the clogs?
I'm going to show you right now. Let's do it. If you have this model, now on any model, if your pieces are not put in correctly and they got gaps in them, you'll lose suction that way. This one I've had for 10 years. It's older. But it's constantly losing suction because this is not clipped in right. I'm not going to hate on his engineering or anything, but it could have been designed a little bit better. So if this is not clipped in, make sure that this is flush right here. Trying to do this with one hand. Okay, this section here, I got it popped off right here. This is one of the filters on this model right here. What you do is you take this out, and you would find this ridiculous if you know about this, but a lot of people don't, and they don't know why their vacuum's not working. Help me get that out, we'll just grab it. I got one hand here. All right, so this is one of your filters right here. And you could find new ones of these on eBay for almost nothing. Just type in the model number. I think this is a DC7. So if yours is a DC something, type in the model number and just type in what you're looking for, if it's like a sponge filter. People sell these and they make aftermarket ones and whatnot. If you want original, type in the word OEM. You'll pay a little bit more, but you get more quality. I also had to replace the hose on this thing right here because it got a cut at the bottom, and I found that for $20. That was a aftermarket one, and it's doing pretty good, so I was pretty happy with that. Take this, put it under water and rinse it, and keep squeezing it, get all the little fine dust out. So you can see mine's pretty clogged up right there. That's probably losing 10% of the suction right there. I'm not gonna blame all the suction, but I'm barely getting anything here. So next, you're gonna unclip this. If I can get it out with one hand. I'm totally jammed in this. Yes, it is dirty. Okay, so I got this. Like I said, I'm trying to do this with one hand. I'm pretty filled up there. I'm gonna tell you guys how to do this. You're gonna have to unclip this plastic base off, and I wish I had somebody help me record here, but I'm gonna unclip it and show you guys what to do next. Right here, but if yours is clogged up, get a little like brush, just a little plastic brush, even a old hair brush or something, and brush this all off. Mine's pretty clean because I cleaned it off about 4 months ago, but you start to use this thing a lot and you get really clogged up. Okay, so that's next. You should be able to see all the way in there. That's one of the things that could be clogged. There's actually a hidden filter in here, and after 10 years I changed it and it was disgusting. The way you get this out, if you have this model, there's hidden filters on all Dysons. I don't know why they do that. The ball one that I have, it's on the side, and you have to like unscrew the side wheel, which is ridiculous. They should tell you where they're at. There should be a video or manual with these things. But go ahead and unclip this one, and then once you clip that up, pops out, and there's another filter hidden inside there. I think they actually tell you. Oh, that's talking about the filter on the side here. So I guess they don't really tell you about that one. If you're sucking something and it gets clogged in this tube here, because what happens when you're vacuuming stuff, it goes under here in a tube and goes up in here, through here into the plastic chamber, and then that's where it ends up in there. So if you have something clogged in here, maybe a toothpick or something, and then around the toothpick gets built a bunch of hair, a bunch of whatever, eventually you'll get clogged up. I push the two buttons on the side and make sure that this is clean. So that's not losing my suction there. And right there, I don't know if you wanna take your mouth and blow on it, probably not. But you wanna make sure that nothing's clogged in there. Also, you got this piece here, and believe it or not, I had this model forever, and I never knew this, and this works on my other model too. When I used this handle piece, I never knew that this rubber piece slides down, so you can actually try to do it with my foot here. Let's see if I can, I'm gonna pause it and show you guys, but this plastic piece right here, this slides up. It took me forever to learn this, about 10 years, that piece slides up right there. Try to do this with my foot, all the way at the end. There it goes, and it's a lot easier when using this handle piece. That's just a tip I wanted to tell you guys about. That doesn't have to do with being clogged, but you can actually, where is it? I think there's two buttons right here. Let me see if I can do it with my hand. I'm one-handed, crippled. Two buttons, see how I did that? And do I have any junk in here? Not sure. but I don't think so. I don't think that's my problem. I could just blow in it or disconnect the piece, but I'm trying to go quick for you guys. Check this out in there, maybe shine a flashlight. Make sure that you're not clogged in there. And these can be clogged at any area. Once you watch this video and learn how to do it, you're gonna know how to unclog your Dyson. I'm pretty sure that my problem was down here. Now check this out, I'm barely getting anything. The brushes, the bristles, are barely exposed to so much hair. And I got three girls in the house and two boys, so this is what we're dealing with. Woman's hair. They'll probably say it's my hair, but no, not sure. Okay, so next you're gonna unclip this. You have to turn these right here, and I don't think I could do it with my finger. Give me a second, we'll get a picture. So there is a tube right here. You see that tube right there? And this is when it gets sucked in. If that's clogged, you're gonna wanna check that out. If not, but here you go. You just take these and you turn them sideways. I like using a penny. You can use a flathead screwdriver, but honestly, a penny works better. And make sure you turn them all the way. If you don't click it all the way like how I just did right now, only halfway, it won't pop out if it's like that. You see that? You don't actually want to do that. Okay, once you get that open, you're able to get in there. And it does got a rubber band on here. So you don't want to like pull this all the way out if you could work with it. What I'm using right here is a razor blade, and I'm gonna slowly cut right here and remove all that hair, and I think I'll be good after this, including, you know, losing the suction from this piece right here. You want to say something?
Why is your hair in there?
Because when your hair falls on the floor, the vacuum picks it up. It did its job, but it didn't get into the plastic container. Let's fix that, right?
That's good for mine and me with hair.
I think so too, Laboos. Let's fix it. My razor blade was pretty dull, but I'm just going to show you guys. I got a scissors and I'm just cutting away right there. I should be able to peel this off. If I had a brand new razor blade, but being lazy, don't want to run to the garage. What?
I have an owie.
I'll fix it. We'll get a Band-Aid. Okay, so then you just want to keep cutting right there. Just show you guys a little bit. I don't want to waste too much of your time. All right, so you see I'm just going to get it on big chunks. If I pull on this really hard, just get all that hair out of there. Clean it up. After you watch this video, you should get a good idea on how to fix your Dyson. If you have this model, okay, look at this one. You click this down right here. I forgot about this little piece right here. Right there, you pull that down. That's on the back side. But that can also get clogged. I've had this one get clogged about 6 or 7 times. But I'm not clogged in there. You can get a flashlight. You can look in there. You're able to look this way, get old stuff out. You raised your hand again. What do you want to say?
Helping you.
Oh, thank you. All right, thanks for watching. What do you want to tell people?
I just
thank you for watching.
And I hope this video helps you guys fix your vacuum.